We thought it'd be really great just to be able to give you a little flavour of what it's going to be like when you come to meet here on a Sunday evening. So this little video will just give you a bit of an idea. So first off, this is outside the church. You can see behind me little yellow markings which helps note the 2 meter signs. I'm going to go inside where it's a bit quieter. So now we're back inside and it's a bit quieter, I thought I would run through what to expect. Before you come, please use the toilet. There is a toilet here, there's one toilet available here, it's for emergencies only. It'd be really great if you didn't need the loo, so please go beforehand. Also, we won't be doing refreshments like we normally do, so if you think you're going to need something, just bring a bottle of water or something with you. The doors will open at 6:45. There'll be 15 minutes to allow for people to come in, so please arrive promptly so we can take people in a COVID secure way, keeping that 2 meter distance. Please remember to book in. Booking in is absolutely essential. And we have got limited spaces, so there's 50 spaces. So I know how we at Hope Church like to leave things right to the last minute. Well, you know, if you want to come, get booking in now. There'll be a link attached to this video and wherever this video is posted, and you can click on the link to book in. So that booking in will be through Church Suite, and you can also find it by going to our church website to the What's On section and choose the date you want to book in for, and make sure you book in each person individually. I appreciate that not everyone has the internet, but if for some reason you are watching and don't have the internet, just ring the church office and leave the details of those who you want to book in. As I said, there's a limited number of spaces to 50 to keep this COVID secure. So if you change your mind, if something comes up, please cancel your booking, even if it's at the last minute. Also, we'll be sending out an informal community agreement to everybody who books in, just to let you know, probably more of what I've just said, what to expect and how we can stay safe so we can enjoy being in God's presence together. So as you come in through the main doors, there'll be stewards from the welcome team outside, first of all reminding you to keep your 2 meters distance. Please at that point have your masks on, ready to come into the building. If you're exempt, wear your lanyard, let us know, and that's fine. So as you come in, there'll be some hand sanitizer that we ask everyone to use, as is the way these days. So hand sanitizer here, and there'll be a QR code to scan as you come in as well. If your phone doesn't have those capabilities, don't worry, there'll be somebody also ticking your name off the list. Our stewarding team, as I've said, will guide you through each step. So I've already said about this step in the foyer here, I'm going to take you into the main hall, just through those doors there, and tell you what to expect next. See you in there. So one of the welcome team will direct you to in through the doors from the foyer to here, or another member of the welcome team will point you towards the front of the church, where there'll be a fourth member of the welcome team waiting for you there. We're going to fill the seats from front to back, and once you've been directed to your seat, please remain in your seat. We need to do that to keep COVID secure. There'll be a little thing put under your seat to say, please clean me. That's just so that we know that that seat's been used, and that's one of the ones that we need to clean. Now, whilst you can't wander around and chat to people, there's nothing to stop you waving or just actually getting your phone out and texting someone. You can see the other side of the room, and I think we've all got quite good at waving these days, thanks to Zoom. Right, so I'm at the front now, and you can see behind me, I'll just step out of the way. This is what it's going to look like. The chairs laid out like this. There'll be a COVID secure gap between different households, so we're keeping things safe that way. If you can remember to keep wearing your mask, that's great, thank you. We'll be starting the service at 7 o'clock promptly. We'll be having worship, we'll be hearing God's word, and we'll be praying together, and sometimes we'll be having communion. So, you know, let's really engage. It'll be different, but that isn't bad. I'd just like to give you a little tip for worship. I went through a period of time where I lost my voice quite a lot, and I found miming really helped me engage when I couldn't actually sing. So yes, there's no singing. The worship team will be singing and we'll be joining in, focusing on God and connecting with Him, and we don't need to use our voices to do that. So as I mentioned, we'll sometimes have communion, and when we do, it'll be in those little thimble, self-contained things with the wafer and the probably Vimto flavoured juice. If we have communion, it would really help us out if you could take your packaging home with you. That would be great. When it's time to leave, the welcome team will direct you out row by row, following the one-way system through those doors over there. Please sanitise your hands on the way out. Once off site, please still remember government guidelines. So if you want to catch up with each other, that's fine to do so off site, but remember rule of six as it is at the moment, socially distanced, or whatever it is at the time. So let's meet together and worship God together and be our church family again together, albeit feeling slightly different. Please remember to book in. Please remember to go to the loo before you come. Please remember to arrive promptly. And then there's hands, space, face. We should all know that now. And come with an expectation to meet with God. I think if we all come with that expectation, then even though it's different, we'll go away blessed and we'll have blessed each other. So look forward to seeing those of you who feel able to come. As Richard said before, we understand not everyone can come, partly because of numbers, partly because of health conditions. We're still running our Sunday mornings as we have been on Zoom, on Facebook, on YouTube. But for those who can come, it'd be great to see you. See you soon. Bye.